Hi, I'm Bowen.
I'm Alira.
And this is our 2001 HZB50 Toyota Coaster that we converted from a school bus into a motorhome.
Come take a look. So this is our door. It's a SKYMAXX caravan door. We replaced this original bus door with the caravan door so that we would have a fly screen for airflow, which we separate like that. And it also gives us permanent ventilation, which we needed for gas compliance.
We also cut out the original door opening mechanism and the original floor. It was full of rust and all that sort of stuff. So we cut it all out and we designed and made this new aluminium checker plate door. It's fully sealed, so when you get this all dirty, then you can get into the bus all nice and clean. To also keep the bus nice and organized, we put lots of storage in. And starting with the storage, we've got a nice big drawer here to put all our beach going bits and pieces in there. So there's snorkels, there's flippers, there's towels, there's mats in that one. And in this side, we've just got shoe organizer, so we can put all our dirty shoes inside there. So up the front, we have built our own little center console here. So we just thought we were gonna need a lot of space while we were driving to put all the bits and pieces, our drink bottles, our wallets, toilet paper. It also holds a fair bit of stuff inside here. We've made it to have two separate consoles, one for the driver, one for the passenger. So you can throw all of your bits and pieces in the front without things moving around. So we've installed a 3000 watt 24 volt inverter charger. So it's an off-grid power inverter. So it'll take, you can see on the screen here, it will select the best voltage to, or the best input to charge the batteries and supply everything. We found that all of the production line campers were using these systems. They're very easy to use. You just plug and play. They're quite cheap compared to all of the other brands that sell all types of bits and pieces. And so far in the 4 years that we've been building this bus, we've had no problems with the inverter. So the fridge that we're using is an Electrolux RM2610. This is quite an old fridge. We actually got it off a guy who pulled apart an old bus to renovate it, and he just gave it to us. It's a three-way fridge, so it can operate on 12 volt, 240 or gas. It's about 110 liters and it has served us very well. We keep a lot of food in here so we can go off-grid for a couple of days and it stays nice and cool, and we can even have ice cream.
So we have got two main seating areas. This we called the recliner because our original idea was that we could push the passenger seat forwards and then that would give us a nice backrest to have a seating area. But since we've been on the road, we mostly just use it to sit on it while we're browsing in the fridge. Then we have the main couch area, which we've built in lots of storage. So we've got storage in the back here, we've got storage down here, and we've also got storage underneath, and our gas box, which we access from the outside. For the cushions, we just used cushions from like their swag mattresses from our local canvas shop, which I cut up and resized to fit on the couch. And then we've just used a linen from Spotlight to make covers, made them removable so that we can wash them if they get dirty on the road.
So the oven and stovetop that we're using is a Dometic DF500DIT, and this unit has three gas burners at the top and one electric burner. It also has a nice gas grill and a pretty big oven.
So these are our overhead cupboards that we made just to give ourselves extra storage, and also we just liked the look of them as a feature in the bus. We used bullnose, hardwood bullnose and miter joints to make the frames, and then attach rattan in the center. A tip, if you're using rattan, make sure you wet it before you install it, and that helps you get a tighter finish. We were planning to put latches on them so they wouldn't open when we're driving, but we've found maybe the weight of them or the hinges themselves are just enough. They're keeping closed when we're driving. They haven't opened until once, which is great. And they're held sort of together with these steel brackets that Bowen made, which bolt directly into existing holes that were in the roof of the bus. So it's really solid. You could hang off it if you wanted to.
The sink that we've used is a Clark sink. It's the one that comes with its own chopping board slash cover. So it kind of turns into more bench space rather than just being a sink. And you can also throw your dishes in there and hide them if you're in a bit of a hurry. The sink was in the caboodle section of Bunnings rather than the normal sink section. Don't know why, but it was. The faucet that we've used is, well, not exactly sure exactly how it got there, but it was in the Bunnings throwout rack. Nothing wrong with it. It works just fine. And we've also incorporated a window that opens behind it, so if you want to, you can have an outside shower. Just when you come back from the beach or something, you just need a quick rinse off, you can just do that. The plumbing that we've put in is all of the S-bends and everything like that, just so the smell doesn't come back up, which is quite important when you're in a small area, but that works really well. So we have made our drawers from scratch, which is definitely a good challenge, but probably recommend getting a cabinet maker to do them because there's a lot of work in there and it kind of takes you away from doing everything else. But the good side of doing your own drawers is that you feel very accomplished. There's a lot that went into these guys here. So we've got our soft close drawer slides from Bunnings, so we get a really nice closing action. We've also got our RV Labs brushed stainless latches that worked really well. So that all clips together really nicely. We have a selection of cupboards, and we also incorporated a table that pulls out so we can sit on the couch and someone can sit on the bed, or we can both sit on the couch and have something to eat, and then it just tucks away. We've got obviously a cupboard underneath the sink, and we've used the same kind of hardware as we used up in the overhead cupboards, and then we used the same RV Labs. We have also made pull-out pantries, which houses all of our food, which is very handy. Instead of keeping it all in cupboards, we can keep it all in the pantry and it's very easily accessed. So our hot water system we have used is up inside the drawers here, and we've used a Truma Ultra Rapid. The system uses 240 volts or gas to produce this hot water, and so far it's had some really great success with some really toasty showers and some really cold nights so far.
So for the curtains, we just used this grey cotton. It's pretty thick. I think it's just from Spotlight. We decided to go for roll-up curtains just so to maximise the light when they're open and not have sort of bulky material obstructing the view through the window. And we just put a little bit of rope up here to attach them, but yeah, they come down pretty easily. And then I sew a little bit of doweling in the bottom, and that just makes it a little bit easier to roll them back up.
So we have used a memory foam mattress to make it easier to get in and out, because a spring mattress is kind of impossible to get in and out. Possible, but it's going to destroy everything on the way in. It's slightly smaller than the width of a double bed, just because we wanted to use a bed lifting mechanism to be able to have extra storage underneath the bed. And because of that, we just had to make the bed slightly skinnier so it missed all of the edges and wasn't wedged in there. The batteries we have used are 220 amp hour hardcore AGM batteries. So far, they've done us great. We haven't had any dramas with them. We've also used a King switch panel. So the King switch panel that we used is a great little unit that has this display so you can turn each individual component on and then turn them all off at the same time. So the components that use this switch panel are all of the 12 volt accessories that we've used in the circuit. So there's a circuit that goes to the fridge, there's a circuit that goes to the water pump, there's some 12 volt lighting at the rear. The hot water system needs a 12 volt input, and the MAXXAIR roof fan uses a input as well. So next to the batteries under the bed, we also have a Shurflo water pump. So this is just a continuous flow caravan pump that's got its own pressure sensing, so it shuts off automatically.
So for most of our walls and for the ceiling, we used Tim Groove and painted everything white, just so it looked a bit less like a log cabin. And yeah, it was pretty easy to use material and.
So the bathroom that we have installed is custom made. We have installed a slide across door to keep it all nice and waterproof. The bathroom itself is all made out of a material called composite aluminium. It is sheets of aluminium that have a plastic bit in the middle and then aluminium the outside. A lot of sign makers use it for their signs, but it's also a really great material for building. We've used a standard 900 by 900 bathroom floor or shower base for the shower base. We just had to cut a little nick out of the corner. We've also installed this boat hatch to the back corner so we can still get in there and change out the tail lights if we need. And we've just installed a Kamek RV shower, and then we've just installed a mixer from Bunnings. It's just a pretty standard type of mixer. In the roof, we have a MAXXAIR brand skylight. It's got the lights in it, as well as being able to fully open and fully lock closed. It does have a blackout blind and a mozzie net in the top. It's also where we keep a bit of our wet area stuff. So just like the fishing rod and stuff like that, once it's been used in the ocean, we can give it a bit of wash off. And we just hang wet towels and things like that in here. We have also got just a Coleman portable toilet. We don't really use it much, except for in areas that require to be fully self-sufficient. So we just use it to tick the box, really.
So this is our wardrobe. It's the part of the bus that's still not quite complete, but we got it at least to a functional stage for our first trip. So we've just got these little pull-out baskets from Bunnings. That's little drawers. And then a little rail along the top to hang our clothes. Our plan is to build more cupboards for the wardrobe in the same style as the overhead cupboards.
So for the lighting, we have used a six position Iconic. It's made by Clipsal, and we've got our three switches for our three sections of light and our dimmable dimmers. And then as for the lights, we've used a dimmable style LED downlight from Bunnings. I can't remember exactly what brand it is, but it's one of the most common ones that you'll find on the Bunnings shelves. We have used a MAXXAIR roof fan in the roof. It's the model that opens and closes and does everything by itself. So this was a lot for ventilation and a lot for gas compliance. So gas compliance, you need a permanent vent in the roof to be able to provide permanent ventilation to the vehicle.
So for the outside, we just opted for glass screen rather than security screen, just so it wouldn't interrupt the view out the windows. We got these made by GGS in town in Alice Springs, and yeah, they
came out. So on the roof, we have a three pairs of roof racks. We've custom made these roof racks because we couldn't really find anything on the market that we were happy with. So we ended up designing our own, and they work amazingly. So far we've done 7,000 Ks in the bus and they haven't moved a millimeter. We also wanted to be able to mount a FIAMMA F45 S-series awning off the side, and the roof racks are just solid as, and they hold that really nicely. And then on the very top, we have two 300 watt solar panels that seem to provide about 27 to 32 volts during the day at peak power, which is exactly what our power system needs to be able to provide optimal battery charge. So for our gas, we have used a system we've made ourselves, which includes two 3.7 kilo gas bottles. They are the same capacity bottle, but they're just different sizes. And then we've used a regulator with the switch, so we know when we're out of one gas bottle, we can just jump to the next one. Two 70 liter water tanks from Custom Coaster Conversions. They're just plastic tanks you can actually buy from most truck trailer supply businesses. They sell them for the underneath of their trucks and trailers. Then we've made our own brackets up to mount into the chassis, and that's all compliant with all of the caravan regs. We've got two on the left hand side for clean water, and then we've got two on the right hand side for grey water. So basically 140 litres of clean, 140 litres of grey. Down the back here we have our Honda Postie bike, which is a CT110, nicknamed Papa Laz. We're towing it on our motorbike carrier that is a Moto brand, and is a Moto 1500. So it's meant for a bike with a 1.5 meter wheelbase. So that concludes the tour of our bus. If there's any questions, comments, or suggestions, please don't hesitate to leave them. Reach out, say good day.
And thanks for following along.
Bye. Hi, I'm Bowen, and this is Undecisive. This is our 2001 HZB50 Toyota Hilux. Click. Cool. Hi, I'm Alira.